to our another lesson on gas laws, and this time around we are dealing with the Graham's law of diffusion. The word diffusion is not new to all of you. You've ever heard it. Those who are taking biology have heard it, and those who are taking physics have still gone through it. So diffusion is the process by which the particles move from a region of high concentration to a region of low concentration. That is what we are going to see at this time. So gases can also move from a region of high concentration to a region of low concentration. And the rule that governs the diffusion of gases is known as the Graham's law of diffusion. And just as we did in our past other gas laws, you are supposed first of all to define the Graham's law of diffusion. And these are some of the things that you need to know as far as laws are concerned. You need to know how to define the law the way it is, or the way you have been given in the book. The way it's given in the book is the way the owner of that law gave. But you realize that because you read 20 minutes to the exam now, then when it comes to the exam time, you write your own things. Some of you, they know very well that whenever you are stating this law, the word pressure has to be mentioned, temperature has to be mentioned, square root of density has to be mentioned. But now the problem comes in which we place those order of those words. We always mark exams for students all over the country, and we just see very funny answers that you guys give. Instead of just telling us that under the same conditions of temperature and pressure, some of you they start by saying under the same square root of density, of which you even wonder who is the teacher that gave you that statement. So first of all, you have to know, before even we go to the, you know, what we are supposed to know as far as this topic is concerned, you have to know how to state the law. And it states that under the same conditions of temperature and pressure, the rate of diffusion of a gas is inversely proportional to the square root of its density. And here, we have around six formulas that you're supposed to know, which relates to this formula. First of all, we know that as a gas is diffusing, it is doing so at a given rate. As a gas is diffusing, it is doing so, taking a certain time. And that gas that is diffusing has a certain molecular mass, and it has a certain density. So all those factors that I've mentioned, we are supposed to put them together so that it can guide you whenever you want to attack a question on this. So first of all, because you will be dealing with several gases, different gases, we always deal with gas A and B, which later on you can see it. It can be carbon dioxide, it can be, you know, carbon dioxide, it can be hydrogen, it can be ammonia, it can be hydrogen chloride gas, any other gas. But for the sake of making your work easier, we always deal with the gas A and B. Now, rate is going to be represented by R. That's why we are always going to write RA over RB. That is now the rate of gas A over the rate of gas B should be equal to, from what we said in our statement of Graham's law of diffusion, we say it inversely proportional to the square root of the density, which is the same as now the square of the density, but now in an inverse way, density of gas B over density of gas A. Then the same, let me just make it a continuous here, over RB, which is the same now as the square root. If you work with molecular mass, it is the same. We just replace the density with molecular mass. In this manner, molecular mass of B over molecular mass of A. And that is what you are supposed to know. Or we can decide, instead of using the rate, we can use time. But remember, time and rate are directly proportional to each other. So I can decide now, I deal with time A over time B. It's going to be square root of density of A over square root of density of B, which is still the same as square root over molecular mass of gas A over molecular mass of gas B. So you see now, whenever we are dealing with time and density, they are directly proportional, because if a gas is denser, it will take a longer time. If a gas has a higher molecular mass, then it will take a longer time to diffuse compared to a gas with a smaller molecular mass. For example, you can take these two gases, hydrogen chloride gas, then we have the ammonia. If you ask which gas will diffuse faster, you simply have to find their molecular masses. The one that has a higher molecular mass is the one that will diffuse the slowest. But the one which is having a smaller molecular mass is the one that will actually diffuse very fast. So in this case now, because the molecular mass for hydrogen chloride gas is somewhere at 6.5, so this one is nitrogen is at 14 plus 3, it gives us 17. So ammonia will diffuse very fast compared to hydrogen chloride, which is having a higher molecular mass. So it's also a factor that affects the rate of diffusion. Again, before we look at the question that I've written on the A of the board there, there's something that I would like you to know, especially when it comes to this formula of time and density and molecular mass. For you to apply this formula here, ensure that the volume of the gases in question are the same. Unless the volume of gas A and B are the same, you are not allowed to use this formula. If another one is 200 centimeters cubic, another one is 150, then you can't work with this formula. Simply because you have to go ahead, use the same volume to calculate the rate. And we have two ways that you can calculate the rate of a gas. The first way that you can calculate the rate of a gas is the distance traveled by that gas over the time. That is the first way. Or the volume of a gas diffusing over the time it takes for that given volume to diffuse. So depending whether you have the distance traveled by the gas or the volume of the gas diffusing, then you can get the rate. But in most cases, you will realize that you will be given in volume, then you are given the time. So you are supposed to use the same to calculate the rate first. After now calculating the rate, you do away with this, you work with this, the first one. That is now the rate and density, or rate and molecular mass. You cannot use this one. You cannot use these two unless the volume of given gases are equal. How can you know? You can be given the volume, or there is somewhere which is mentioned that the gases are identical. Anytime you hear that the gases are the same, then it means also the volume are the same. So you are free to work with this formula. So you can look for as many questions as possible, then you try to work on this. But for the sake of our lesson today, there is a question here I would like us to discuss together. A sample of a known compound gas X is shown by analysis to contain sulfur and oxygen. The gas requires 28.3 seconds to diffuse through a small aperture into a vacuum. An identical number of oxygen molecules pass through the same aperture in 20 seconds. Then you have been told now to determine the molecular mass of gas X. You have been asked to find the molecular mass of gas X. Meaning what? The formula you are going to take, first of all, it should have a molecular mass in it. It should have a molecular mass in it. So here, we can work with either the formula here, or we use the second one here. First, we are allowed to work with any of them because we have been told the gases are identical. The oxygen gas given is identical to gas X. So we can work with any. But since we don't have rate, but we have time, now we can work with time and the molecular masses. So you allow me to wrap this, then we rewrite the same up here. So we just now work with time A over time B. It's the same as the square root of molecular mass of A over molecular mass of B.
That's what we are going to work with, so that we can unravel this question. This is what we require. But now, since we have the actual gases, we have X and we have oxygen, we are going to replace it. Where we have A, we put X, for example. Where we have B, we put oxygen. Then now we will be able to continue with our question. So TA is going to be TX over TO2, which is the same as the square root of molecular mass of X over molecular mass of oxygen. Then we replace, because from the question there, we have time for X, we have time for oxygen, and we have time for, and then we have the molecular mass for oxygen, we know it. So time for oxygen, from the question, we are told that an identical number of oxygen molecules pass through the same aperture in 20 seconds. The other one will take 28.3. So it's going to be 28.3 over 20. Then it's going to be the same as the square root of mmx over the molecular mass of oxygen. An oxygen atom has 16, but now our oxygen molecule is going to have 32. That's what it is. So we can do this from here. We can use a calculator, 28.3 divided by 20. We get 1.415 to be the same as, or to be equal to, the square root of mmx over 32. So how can we remove this square root here? We square both sides. When we square both sides, we will have, we square our answer here, then we are going to have 2.00, so I'm just trying 2, which is the same as now mmx over 32. So that mmx is going to be 64, and that is the molecular mass of gas X the question was asking. Thank you. Continue working on more examples. Thank you.